wondered what it's really like to be a Hollywood action man? Well, no, I'm going to tell you. Or maybe a search rescue pilot? Well, let's find out. Our next guest has done both. Please welcome Jerry Grayson to Studio 10.
Thank you.
I guess we'll start at the beginning, Jerry. You became, at 17, one of the youngest helicopter pilots ever to serve in the Royal Navy, which is just incredible. Is it something that you always wanted to do? Where did you get your inspiration from?
It is, yeah. I was inspired by aviators, and you know, Neil Armstrong walked on the moon a couple of years before I was going to leave school, and so astronaut was perhaps a bit high to aim at, but I always wanted to be a pilot, and it was a dream come true, and I think I still hold that record today because they became graduate entry after that.
You were quite a pilot, though.
Thank you.
You in fact were awarded some medals.
I was.
Tell us about the circumstances that led to that.
Thank you. Yeah, that's the Air Force Cross, which I was given by the Queen at the end of my military career, and that's the highest award that's the highest award for gallantry in the UK. Mm. And this one is from the Greek government, and that's their highest award for gallantry in peacetime. So I've got.
You're the most highly decorated naval person in peacetime, aren't you?
Yes. Mm. Yes.
Wow.
Yeah. Yeah.
And so, what did you do?
How do we get one?
You can have that one. I spent more than my fair share of time flying search and rescue missions down in the south coast of the UK, down in Cornwall. And if you've been watching the Poldark series, you'd know that they're fairly steep cliffs and rolling waves. Mm. So a huge number of rescues down there, and the Queen gave me that at the end of it.
Very nice. Helicopters seem, you know, when you're in a helicopter, it's great being up there, but they seem to me to be very difficult to manoeuvre. But clearly they're not, if you're an expert like you.
Well, there comes a point where suddenly you get the idea and it becomes natural to you. Mm. Initially, it seems impossible to do. And then there comes a day where you go, oh, wow, I can do this. Mm. Of course, all the way through the training, it's a couple of years of that. And then you get to a stage where you rely on the rest of the crew and you're working out very much as a team. So when I'm hovering next to the cliffs, with the blades just a couple of feet away from the edge, I'm relying on my crewman who's saying, OK, just keep coming right 2 inches, right another couple of inches. And so it's very much a team effort to achieve that.
Now, Jerry, as if being a highly decorated Navy pilot wasn't enough, since leaving the military, you've gone to work on movies as a helicopter pilot. What sort of movies have you worked on?
The very first one I did was a James Bond movie, A View to a Kill.
Oh, wow!
And, which bit?
Do you remember... you would remember this, you were in the UK at the time, I think, when Grace Jones got into trouble for punching Russell Harty in the face.
Not with me, she didn't.
No, OK. And it was with some trepidation a couple of weeks later that I was doing this movie, and I made the mistake.
From a helicopter, was that you doing that?
I wasn't watching that. No, I wasn't. No, I can't.
Did you fly Grace Jones?
Were you flying the helicopter?
No, I blew dirt into her face, which wasn't. It wasn't a terribly good idea, and the director called me on the radio and said, Jerry, do you need fuel now? And I said, no, I'm okay. He said, honestly, go and get fuel and take about 3 hours doing it.
Wow. Have you ever been in a plane, like a normal passenger plane, and just noticed that the pilots made a mistake and had to step in? Or have you ever been called to step in? Are there any pilots on the plane? Please, we need some help. Has that ever happened?
It's actually the sort of fantasy of all helicopter pilots that suddenly the hostess is going to come running down going, oh, the pilots have passed out. Can anybody fly the plane? But the reality is that a helicopter pilot would get into the cockpit of an airliner and go, God, a lot of dials and switches in.
Jerry, you also directed helicopter units at the Athens Olympics. Yes, what was that like?
That was full on. My wife is a TV producer, and so she was running the organisational side of it, and I was running the aviation side. We had 10 helicopters, and it was a last-minute gig, so as you can see on the picture, they're all lined up. And we actually brought all of those down from the UK because it was a last-minute thing, and we wanted guys flying them that we knew. Very full on. I did pull rank and fly the opening ceremony because that's the fun bit.
Oh. What a life you've led, Jerry. It's been such an honour talking to you. Thanks for coming in.
Thanks so much for having me.
And you can grab a copy of Jerry's incredible book, Rescue Pilot, Cheating the Sea. It's available online and in all good bookstores.